Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to securely access a secret in an Azure Key Vault from an Azure virtual machine. Let's assume you are developing an application and want to deploy it to an Azure virtual machine. It is very common that the application needs to access a backend database. Let's say it is a SQL Server database, which requires your application to provide a connection stream. And the connection string will include your database username and password. So we know it is a bad idea to store the password in your application configuration files locally. A better solution is to store your password or connection string as a secret in an Azure Key Vault. Now, the next question is that how can you access the securely stored connection string from your application or your Azure virtual machine? Do you need to provide another password? Otherwise, any people can access your stored password or connection string. Use them to connect to your database and access or modify your data. So we will need to have another mechanism to securely access our secret stored in Azure Key Vault. And this mechanism should not leverage password. Otherwise, it is going to be a chicken and egg problem. So luckily, this is easy to achieve on Azure. We can use a feature called Managed Identity to assign an Azure resource and identity. In this particular case, the Azure resource is your virtual machine. And this service was formerly known as Managed Service Identity or MSI. So the identity assigned to your virtual machine is very similar to an Azure user. You can then grant permissions or roles to this identity as a normal user. And the application running inside the virtual machine can then acquire the role and use its assigned permission to access the relevant Azure resource. In this case, the Azure resource is the secret stored in your Azure Key Vault. Now, the application can access the connection string without providing a password, and then use that connection string to connect to your SQL Server database securely. Okay, so enough talking. Let's jump to Azure Portal and see how to configure this. Here I have already connected to my Azure Portal. If we go to the Key Vaults management page, here I've already created a Key Vault. If we go into this Key Vault and underneath the secrets, I have a secret called SQL connection string. And if I clicked the secret and select the current version, here you can see the secret value has been masked. You can click this show secret value to see the secret value. And in this case, my secret is an SQL Server connection string. And let's imagine that we can use this connection string to access my SQL Server instance running at somewhere. And also I have an Azure virtual machine VM01, which is going to run the application that leads to access my SQL Server database by using the identity assigned to this virtual machine. By default, Azure virtual machine do not have any identity assigned. So I'm going to go to the identity setting under the settings section. And from here, I can assign this virtual machine an identity. As you can see from this page, we have two types of managed identities, system assigned and user assigned. The system assigned identity has a one-to-one relationship with the Azure resource that it is assigned to. Each resource can only have one system assigned managed identity, and the system assigned managed identity will also be deleted if the relevant resource is deleted. On the other hand, the user assigned managed identities are created as standard Azure resources and can exist independently from other Azure resources. This type of managed identities have a many-to-many relationship with the Azure resources they are assigned to. That is to say, a single resource can have multiple user-assigned managed identities. Similarly, a single user-assigned managed identity can be shared across multiple Azure resources. In this exercise, I will be using system-assigned managed identity. So I'm going to change the status from off to on and save. The portal reminds me that this virtual machine will be registered with Azure AD, and once it is registered, this VM can be granted permissions to access Azure resources. That's exactly what I want. So I would click yes to register. Now, this virtual machine is registered with Azure AD with an system assigned managed identity. Let's go back to the Key Vault. Under the settings section, if we click the Access Policy appellate, on this page, we can add access policies to assign permissions to virtual machine VM01. So I'm going to click Add Access Policy. And because I want VM01 to be able to retrieve the secret or the connection string from this Key Vault, I will select Secret Management as the template, which automatically selects all the secret management operations for the secret permission. Alternatively, you can choose individual operations from this list. And as you can see from here, you can also use Azure Key Vault to manage your keys and certificates. And you can select the operations for them from here as well. Another aspect of this access policy is which principal you want to assign these permissions to. Principal is just another fancy name for identity. Currently, nothing has been selected. If we clicked the link here, long selected, a new blade will pop up. From here, we can search the VM by typing VM01 in the search bar. And I'm going to select VM01 from the list, then click select to add this virtual machine to the access policy. Now I have selected the permissions and the principal. Let's click the add button to create this access policy. And don't forget to save. So at this point, the application running inside a virtual machine VM01 should be able to retrieve the secret or connection string stored in our Key Vault. To verify this, I have connected to this virtual machine via SSH. And on this Linux virtual machine, I have installed PowerShell Core and Azure PowerShell module. So I can run PowerShell by typing pwsh. And from the PowerShell prompt, I can run the Azure PowerShell commandlets. To access the secret stored in our Azure Key Vault, firstly, we will need to acquire the system assigned identity by connecting to Azure with managed identity. So here I used dash identity as the parameter for the command connect dash AZ account. This parameter tells the command to connect to Azure using the identity assigned to this virtual machine instead of asking for a credential. As you can see here, that I logged into Azure with the MSI account, which is the short name for managed service identity, and I did not provide any credentials or passwords at all. Now we should be able to get the connection string from the Key Vault. Let's use the Azure PowerShell command get-az-key-vault-secret to fetch the secret object and store it to a variable. So this command needs at least two parameters. The first one is the vault name, and the second one is the secret name. Now the secret object has already been stored into this secret variable. The secret value property of this object is an encrypted secure string. So we will use convert from secret string to convert it to a plain text. And here we go. We have successfully retrieved the collection string stored in the Key Vault from this virtual machine. All right, thank you for your watching. If this video is useful, please give it a like, subscribe, comment, and share. That's it. Until next time, take care.